The push for legal pot in New York State renewed today by former Erie County Executive Joel Giambra, who is running for governor. 7 Eyewitness News reporter Jeff Rusak has more now on the pitch and why legal pot advocates say it both raises and saves money for the state.
Legalize recreational marijuana to fix the state's infrastructure. That's what Republican gubernatorial candidate Joel Giambra is proposing.
For New York State not to get serious about ending criminal activity and the black market underground economy makes no sense.
Giambra is not alone in wanting to legalize pot. The Western New York chapter of the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Laws, or NORML, also wants legalization in the state.
It'd be far more sensible for them to just get ahead of this.
The group believes the state could gain tax revenue as well as eliminate costs. They believe upwards of $700 million a year could be saved by not prosecuting New Yorkers for marijuana offenses.
Could you imagine all the things we could do with $700 million that would actually benefit people?
Colorado legalized the sale of the drug in 2014. They've raised over $250 million in taxes since then. But the state has also seen a 40% uptick in fatal car crashes, according to the NHTSA. Now, there have been legalization bills in Albany before. They have all failed. Last Thursday, the New York State Assembly held a public hearing on the possibility of legalizing recreational marijuana. Most who spoke in favor. The former Erie County executive is running for governor, and he thinks legalization could make the state some serious cash.
Nobody in Albany wants to raise taxes. Nobody wants to cut services. But yet we have this huge deficit. So we're going to have to figure out how to make this work.
Jeff Rusak, 7 Eyewitness News.
Now, the legalization question has been a hot topic on our Facebook page today. We put out a quick show of hands poll to see if people are behind it. And overwhelmingly, 85% of the nearly 800 people who have voted say they are. You can vote as well by heading over to the WKBW Facebook page.